All right, welcome back, everybody.
Welcome back
to Arkham Asylum. Where we are, Batman.
Harley forgot to close the vents.
Look for an exit.
I should scan the room. Look for an exit.
Oh my god, I hate these sequences in video games. They have, these are a lot in Uncharted where it's like, oh, press A to open this door. Keep pressing A, now press Y, then press X. I don't want to press a various sequence of buttons to watch Drake struggle to open a very heavy door. You know, like, it's cool. I'll just watch him do it.
Sorry, feed's down. Comms are up and down like crazy.
A Riddler trophy.
Not good. I'll keep trying.
I have never found all the Riddler trophies in a game.
Now, this may sound crazy, and I know we're playing a Batman game, but I can't help but have this instinct. If I were in this situation where Batman is, I would go into the vent and stay there until all of this blows over. that does not look fun.
What is that stuff?
Joker toxin. Listen, the room is full of poison gas. Anyone caught in there is dead.
Yeah, see? Serial killer. Also mass murderer. He does qualify for...
But that's what I mean, is that do you still call them... Like, at a certain point, do you still call them a serial killer?
Well, supervillain isn't a real term, right? So if Joker was real, you would never classify him as a supervillain. And if you do, then, I mean, that means that Hitler is a supervillain.
Like, Hitler absolutely was a supervillain. He's legitimately a real-life supervillain. He wanted to take over the world, had a vision for the world, and
you're going to be fine. He's basically Lex Luthor, but less humanized.
I mean, honestly, right? Like, he's straight up a villain.
Hold on a little longer, Steve.
You know?
Where is
sorry Nazis that I hate Hitler?
No. Where is sorry Nazis? Yeah, if you're a Nazi, go ahead and unsubscribe. We don't need you. we're good. Like, but oh, I see. He's over there. He's over there. He can't hold this guy.
Oh, I see. Okay, I'm trying to look for a way to reach. Oh,
talk to guard.
Can I jump up here?
You want to talk to that blue glowing skeleton guy?
Well, I'll go up there and save that guy.
There's another one. Yeah. Oh man, there's so many people that are out of
fall. I'm going after the animal who did this.
The animal who did this. That is an insult to animals.
Steve was trying to get to the control panel at the end of the room.
I can't believe he left me here.
I would do that literally all the time. If I had a cape like that.
Oh no. Oh what?
What's a criminal?
But we helped him. Maybe he was a good guy. Oh,
that's
no.
True. You know what? That
my instincts
too fast, Batman.
Yeah, wait.
There's the
you're like, ah, criminal. Punch him in the face, because criminals have no redeeming qualities. You know, like fuck, shit, dude. Like he literally said, he left me here. I can't believe it. Maybe he would turn. Maybe he'd help you. You don't know. Batman punching.
You know what? I do gotta say that was pretty cruel. Especially because that guy is kind of hurt looking at the moment. Sorry, I got a Discord message from Once Upon a Taco.
Taco. He must know we're recording.
Yes, he must.
He wants to be featured.
Of course. Why would anyone message me otherwise?
Yeah. There's no point.
All these dead people. That's kind of sad. Also, what are we supposed to be doing right now?
Well, we saved that one guy, and then we saved the other guy, but then immediately punched him in the face.
we all, handle violence in different ways. Well, I guess this is unlocked now.
Right. All these people died because of the Joker's laughing poison gas.
I want to get in there.
Which, you know, in terms of poison gas, I would rather laugh myself to death than other things.
You know, you say that, but have you read about what it's actually like to die of laughter?
No.
It is apparently vicious.
That's tragic.
Like, because you suffocate, you choke.
I guess that's fair.
Yeah.
That one guy, there was some, I want to say he was Greek or Roman. I apologize, I mix up some of the historical figures between the two of those countries. There was some guy who died of laughter at his own joke.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't, you know what? I'll look it up. Because I want to know.
Yeah, that sounds... Oh, this is... Just use this.
Guy who died of laughter. Death from laughter, Wikipedia.
Clearly that doesn't do anything. Nope, that doesn't work
Fascinating.
Either.
Fascinating.
What the fuck are we doing?
Okay, so you're right. It's either cardiac arrest or asphyxiation.
Yeah, yeah. It's a pretty terrible way to go, actually, dying of laughter.
Ancient Greece, I think, is the guy I'm thinking of.
Yeah, there's not...
Hold on.
It's a little scary to think about, but there's not really a good way to die besides in your sleep, you know, peacefully. Oh, this just opens. Wow, I'm a fucking idiot.
What are you waiting for?
There's even arrows. That's embarrassing.
Okay, it's an ancient Greek philosopher, and despite the fact that we are currently doing a playthrough of Assassin's Creed Odyssey, I cannot pronounce Greek names. So I'm going to do my best here. Chrysippus?
Let me see it. Crispus.
Crispus?
Or no, yeah. Wait, no, maybe it is Chrysippus, actually. It actually is Chrysippus. It is Chrysippus.
Get fucked, idiot. He is a Greek philosopher, and he allegedly died because... Let's see.
Allegedly.
Well, it's not confirmed. This is just what was written, right? You know, we don't actually 100% know.
Right, that's just what people claim to have...
Right.
Okay, I think Batman was trying to kneel here to look at this smiley face, and then I just sprinted right past. This is a pretty good spray paint job.
I'm trying to find the death part of his notes, and it doesn't seem to be a thing. Oh, okay, here we go. Oh, I'm totally not moving at this cutscene.
I will find you.
Ooh, I'm counting on it. Just not yet.
I don't remember what this part is. It's just one
is
of
this,
his.
Is this, Oh, right!
I vaguely remember this now.
I do vaguely remember this.
God damn, does this game hold up? Like, seriously.
It does look very good, and it's quite a few years old now, right?
Yeah!
Okay, he... According to some guy, he was 73, and he died when he was watching a donkey eat some figs. And he said, "Now give the donkey a drink of pure wine to wash down the figs," and then started laughing, and then died in his fit of laughter.
That's not a terrible way to go.
No.
In the sense that, like...
It's not a good... It's not that funny, though. Like, maybe you had to be there.
Have you heard what's supposed to be the funniest joke in the world?
No.
It's, Oh, I see. You're supposed to dodge it forever, I guess.
Well, that was he just goes through.
He just died.
Well, he went through the...
Self needs stronger test subjects. Seeing as how I'm feeling generous, I'll give you this one for free. Knock me off, I dare you. End this. Pull the plug. Stop me once and for all.
Batman, don't be a pussy.
You pussy. Come on.
Dude, he's playing you.
You're getting too predictable, Bats. Well, I'd love to stay in shape.
God, what an adrenaline rush Joker must get from this kind of shit, though. Like, just fucking with him like that.
I actually feel like Joker probably had a contingency plan for that.
Okay, but so yeah, do you know what the funniest joke in the world is?
No, of course not. So you've never finished your sentence.
Oh, right. So the funniest joke in the world is this. It's like a story joke. It's like anecdotal, right? And what? It's,
Batman, I'm over here.
Batman, I'm over here. I don't know where that is.
Batman! I don't either.
You unlocked the Wayne Tech upgrade for the XP meter. Oh, cool.
Wayne Tech upgrade? Don't you mean Bat upgrade? We can't let people know our one secret identity, because as we all know, Batman only has one of those and is not multiple people.
A Nexus throw. Special combo takedown. Oh, I wish we had taken this, actually. This would have been way better. I think it wasn't unlocked, though. Okay, so the funniest joke in the world is there's two hunters who go out hunting.
Okay.
This already doesn't sound funny.
It's...
Get in here before more of them
quick,
come.
Quick, get in here before more of them come. What the fuck are you... Where are you?
I don't know. I don't know either. Go, just
I can't
try
go... Oh, this is broken. Okay.
He sounds that way.
He sounds that way? Okay, because I'm not wearing a headset. That probably doesn't help.
No. But that being said, yeah.
Okay, so the funniest joke in the world, two hunters go out hunting. In the middle of it, one of them passes out. He just collapses, and he's like faint, and he's like, he's not breathing or anything like that. And so the other hunter's just like, oh my god. Grabs his phone, calls 911, and is like, oh my god, this guy, my hunting pal, he's dead. I think I need some help, and they're like, okay, calm down. First, let's make sure he's dead, okay? So then it's quiet for a moment, and then they hear a bang, and then it's like, okay, now what?
I even have you here to keep a smile on my face.
Not for long.
That's the end of the joke.
I don't like that joke.
I love that joke.
That's supposed to be the funniest joke in the world.
It's not actually the funniest in that it'll get the most laughter. Oh yeah, by the way, that guy from earlier betrays everyone here.
Oh, sure. So this is the low.
Holly's looking forward to it. Maybe I'll film it and post.
Yeah, tragic. Anyways, but yeah, so it's not the funniest joke in the world in the sense of like it's the most laughable one. It's the funniest joke in the world because no matter where you're from in the world, you're probably going to at least find it a little bit funny. Like it's the humor that carries throughout the world the most.
I guess that's fair.
Like, even if you didn't like the joke, you can appreciate it. You're like, oh, okay, I get it, right?
Yeah,
like, wordplay.
Yeah, I definitely got it.
Yeah.
Don't worry, I'm getting it back.
But I don't think it's supposed to be, like, actually, like, the most uproariously hilarious joke
Joker
of all time.
Not win.
I mean, nothing compares to the Welder joke,
where
of course,
he was taken.
So.
A guard named Frank Bull.
Which is the best joke of all time.
I'll find Frank,
yes.
I'll find your father.
We're not gonna say it, though.
You don't want to hear the welder joke?
Please.
Again?
No.
For, like, the 20th time?
I do love it. I just,
I can't listen to that joke. I'm not gonna tell it again.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not gonna tell it again for
another
year.
It's just really long.
It's a long joke.
I will always remember that one time when we were talking about jokes with Vi and some other people in Discord call, and of course, you were going to say that joke, and then Vi cut you off and then asked me for a joke, and then I said, all right, I'm going.
Yes! That was so funny, because they knew not to ask me for a joke, because hot tip, if you ever ask me to tell a joke, I will tell the welder joke.
Yes, and...
I am not a great joke teller. I can do like quips and stuff like that, but I am not a great joke teller, so I will always tell the welder joke.
I genuinely think the welder joke is very good. It's just not.
It's not actually a funny joke. It's a joke. So it's just meant to piss you off.
It's
Oracle. I'm at the holding cell.
There's a few things that are not in taste in that joke.
Exactly.
However,
sensitive snowflake cuck, maybe.
I think it's hysterical, personally.
I think it's tremendous. But yes, I do. I mean, it's never funny to anyone whenever I've told it to them. It's only ever funny to me.
Yes.
And that's fine with me.
It's definitely funnier for the person saying it because you get to see the look of disappointment on the person's face when you finish the joke and it's not hilarious at all to anybody. And then they look at you and you're just like, why was that the ending? And you're just like, yeah. The only other joke that I can think of is, so as a kid, I had this band teacher who was also my orchestra teacher as well. This is an elementary school, not middle school.
Mm-hmm.
And perhaps you remember him, Mr. Boris?
Not really.
No? Okay. Well, Point is, I figured that was a generic enough name that didn't matter if I said it. So Mr. Boris was, you know, this teacher, and his whole thing was he would tell us a joke every week, and then the next week when we saw him again, he would tell a different joke, right? So I think these jokes are relatively well known, but there's one that was like it didn't really have an ending, like it was just this the story about this guy who wants to propose to his wife or, you know, his girlfriend or something, and he loses the ring, and there's no punchline. It just ends with this story with him losing the ring, and then we're all like confused, like we're fifth graders, and we're like, shit, did we not understand that joke properly? Like damn, I don't remember there being a punchline. I don't get it. But we all like pretended to laugh, you know, because we're like, yeah, we're 10, what's going on, you know? And the next week, he fucking starts up, you know, his new joke.
Okay, I'm sorry to interrupt you. Is there an audio cue that happens around here?
No, I have
here?
No clue what's going on right now. There's no audio clue.
Because I don't really know what we're supposed to do here.
I don't either.
Okay, go ahead and continue.
Bowles dropped his flask. Sloppy. Let's see what the forensic scanner picks
Bowles
up.
Bowles dropped his flask. Sloppy.
That's mean. So he comes in the next week and he says, you know, so two people Oracle. Go to a,
that's great.
You know,
I'm grabbing every
they go to a seafood place and, you know, they sit down, they order some fish, and then in the fish is this ring. And the idea is that the two
jokes
are really
are
connected.
That, there's another famous joke that's similar to that. I do love that joke. It's not not quite the joke that I remember. The one is that's like, oh, like it's something to do with like a cookie and a fish or something like that. It's like three parts.
Yes, that's the same joke.
It's
I
the same
not
joke.
Remember.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, that is definitely it though.
Okay. Do I need to keep scanning this?
But yeah, what's crazy about that joke though is to get it to like to tell that joke properly, you actually have to know what you're doing.
Yes.
Not anybody can walk into that joke and tell it properly, because most of the time people are just gonna look at you and be like, I don't fucking get it and I don't care. Like, you know, because you have to set it up properly.
It's funny.
Or I guess tell it to 10-year-olds.
Because I do you remember that bit from Harmontown where they were talking about how like writers are terrible joke tellers?
Sure.
You know, like, and I not that I'm a writer, but I do feel the same way. That I'm a terrible joke teller. Like, because I spend so much time trying to set up like a narrative. Mm-hmm. You know, like, it's a joke, right? It's just a joke. It doesn't have to have a narrative. It doesn't have to be something we need attached to it, right?
You try to make it more realistic by adding things.
Yeah, exactly.
That doesn't actually do anything for the joke, and so it just ends up being more long-winded. And the longer it takes for you to say the joke, the less people care.
Yes, because then they expect a heavier punchline.
A really good punchline. Yeah, exactly.
Oh my God, it's Harley Quinn.
Mr. J doesn't want you following us just yet.
Oh no! Legitimately one of my greatest fears.
Huh.
What? That's how
I
work.
Feel like he waited a really long time. To move that stuff. No way. Like, he was watching it, and then like about 30 seconds before it hit, he was like, watch out, you know.
Oh, that wasn't even what I was aiming for, but I'll take it. Wow, Harley Quinn, how is Batman gonna climb up an elevator shaft? He's never done that before with his all trusty grappling hook. Which I have to say, besides the Batarang, the grappling hook has to probably be like Batman's most iconic utility, right? Like, it's not a Batman sequence unless he fucking grappling hooks away.
It's true. It does make me wonder how much of this Like, are they actually, is Joker's obviously a crazy genius, right, or whatever. But it makes me wonder how much of this did the Joker plan, and how much of this is he just like, well, Batman's, you know, he always seems to figure it out and beat me. I don't know, like, I guess I'll never understand because I'm not a crazy psycho. At least as far as you guys know. And I could understand the concept of being a crazy murderer if you're always winning. But the moment you have an arch nemesis who wins every time, like Batman, mm-hmm. wouldn't you just wanna be like, fuck it. I'll get a day job, you know, like I'll. Well, because this isn't working.
Because Joker's whole shtick is he doesn't even give a crap if he wins.
He's just
because he knows that Batman's not gonna kill him, and so now and if Batman ever does kill him, then he wins.
Right.
Right. Like, oh yeah, I got Batman to break his code. I got Batman to kill me. You know what a pussy. You know, like.
Yeah.
His whole thing is I don't give a shit because as long as I get to keep playing the game, it is so meaningless to me.
I guess that's true. It's like the DBZ Tien and Vegeta, you know, thing where it's like, yeah, Vegeta can kill me, but if he does that, then I win.
Yeah,
because
I got under his skin. You know, I pissed him off enough. We are approaching the end of the episode here. Let's get out of this elevator shaft first. And
that's
then
what she said.
Episode. What?
Shaft. I don't know. I'm sorry.
Shaft.
So that's a there. Beetle. Yeah.
It's a Chronicle of Arkham.
That doesn't sound like a real thing.
Cipher Chronicle.
I am the spirit of Amadeus Arkham.
What?
Okay, through as cool actions, as that is, I have we don't really have time for that. I'm trying to get out of an elevator.
Through my actions, we have saved.
Joker was right. This is easy.
Oh my god, I love punching people. I'm really interested. I want to know how they got those spikes coming out of their head.
I believe on some level they've all taken like a little bit of like this Joker drug.
Not yet, but I'm getting close.
That like juices them up and makes them physically stronger.
It does make me feel like they, because I'm looking at them, I'm like, man, all the inmates sure are generic Borderland people. Like,
all the psychos.
There's not a guy who looks like he's normal but is just insane. You know, like the. There's no Ted Bundys walking around
this
asylum.
No Ted Bundys, yeah. No Charles Mansons. Yeah. Okay, well, it's 23 minutes, so thanks for joining us, gang.
Yes, thank you for tuning in to another episode of Batman Booty Asylum.
Booty Asylum.
Booty Asylum. Perfect. That's the name of this episode is going to be.
Great.
I got it. Booty Asylum. And we will see you guys next time. All right.
Bye, guys.
Bye.